Paradise is the eternal center of the universe of universes and the abiding place of the universal Father, the eternal Son, the infinite Spirit, and their divine coordinates and associates. This central isle is the most gigantic organized body of cosmic reality in all the master universe. Paradise is a material sphere as well as a spiritual abode. All of the intelligent creation of the universal Father is domiciled on material abodes, hence must the absolute controlling center also be material, literal. And again it should be reiterated that spirit things and spiritual beings are real. The personal presence of the universal Father is resident at the very center of the upper surface of this well-nigh circular, but not spherical, abode of the deities. This paradise presence of the universal Father is immediately surrounded by the personal presence of the eternal Son, while they are both invested by the unspeakable glory of the infinite Spirit. God dwells, has dwelt, and everlastingly will dwell, in this same central and eternal abode. We have always found him there and always will. The universal Father is cosmically focalized, spiritually personalized, and geographically resident at this center of the universe of universes. Since you are beginning to glimpse the enormousness of the material universe discernible even from your astronomical location, your space position in the starry systems, it should become evident to you that such a tremendous material universe must have an adequate and worthy capital. A headquarters commensurate with the dignity and infinitude of the universal ruler of all this vast and far-flung creation of material realms and living beings. In form, paradise differs from the inhabited space bodies. It is not spherical, it is definitely ellipsoid, being 1/6 longer in the north-south diameter than in the east-west diameter. The central isle is essentially flat, and the distance from the upper surface to the nether surface is 1/10 that of the east-west diameter. These differences in dimensions, taken in connection with its stationary status and the greater out-pressure of force energy at the north end of the isle, make it possible to establish absolute direction in the master universe. The central isle is geographically divided into three domains of activity. 1. Upper Paradise. 2. Peripheral Paradise. 3. Nether Paradise. We speak of that surface of paradise which is occupied with personality activities as the upper side, and the opposite surface as the nether side. The periphery of paradise provides for activities that are not strictly personal or non-personal. The Trinity seems to dominate the personal or upper plane. The unqualified absolute, the nether or impersonal plane. We hardly conceive of the unqualified absolute as a person, but we do think of the functional space presence of this absolute as focalized on nether paradise. On upper paradise there are three grand spheres of activity. The deity presence. The most holy sphere. And the holy area. The vast region immediately surrounding the presence of the deities is set aside as the most holy sphere and is reserved for the functions of worship, trinitization, and high spiritual attainment. The holy area, the outlying or residential region, is divided into 7 concentric zones. Paradise is sometimes called the Father's house since it is his eternal residence, and these 7 zones are often designated the Father's paradise mansions. The inner or first zone is occupied by paradise citizens and the natives of Havona who may chance to be dwelling on paradise. The next or second zone is the residential area of the natives of the 7 superuniverses of time and space. This second zone is in part subdivided into 7 immense divisions, the paradise home of the spirit beings and ascendant creatures who hail from the universes of evolutionary progression. Each of these sectors is exclusively dedicated to the welfare and advancement of the personalities of a single superuniverse. But these facilities are almost infinitely beyond the requirements of the present seven superuniverses. The central aisle ends abruptly at the periphery, but its size is so enormous that this terminal angle is relatively indiscernible within any circumscribed area. The peripheral surface of Paradise is occupied, in part, by the landing and dispatching fields for various groups of spirit personalities. Since the non-pervaded space zones nearly impinge upon the periphery, all personality transports destined to Paradise land in these regions. Neither upper nor nether Paradise is approachable by transport Superna Fim or other types of space traversers. The seven master spirits have their personal seats of power and authority on the seven spheres of the spirit, which circle about Paradise in the space between the shining orbs of the sun and the inner circuit of the Havona worlds. But they maintain Force focal headquarters on the Paradise periphery. Here the slowly circulating presences of the seven supreme power directors indicate the location of the seven flash stations for certain Paradise energies going forth to the seven superuniverses.